this topic in particular is so scattered. And it's, there's no one book that you can really cite that tells the full story. And that's what I kind of want eventually to do. I don't even think this film did it, you know? But I think that eventually there'll be an opportunity for me to create something that will do that, you know? So some of these areas for expanded research that I felt like really do that, they kind of go into this larger comprehensive topic. Because if you want to know who African Americans are, you have to look at all the parts. You know, and in order to understand where we could end up, you know, it's also good to look at how we got here. Mm-hmm. So, for instance, like one of the things that stood out to me, I didn't know anything about the Atlanta riots. I possibly lost a family member in. And I didn't find out about it until I'm, you know, beat myself over the head trying to figure out what happened to my family on these records. And I'm talking to one of our production coordinators about it. And he said, well, did you ever think about the Atlanta riots? And I was like, well, I wasn't familiar with that. I went to school up north too, you know, and we really didn't teach that stuff. And then I also taught, even for a point of time when I was learning in Virginia, nothing. And I came down here and I was like, there really isn't too much that talks about it down here, where it happened. And so when you start looking into it, one of the things I thought was really interesting was that what led up to it wasn't too different than what you see contemporary, you know, in the contemporary period. So, and that's why I phrased it like that in the film, you know, it was racially charged political rhetoric, unsubstantiated claims in the news, that led to actual people losing their lives. And how is that so much different than what we see now? You know, how far removed are we from that? And so in order to understand, and I would say, the reason why we're probably seeing this again and not addressing it with a certain level of urgency is because we don't address it in the historical context. We don't talk about it from back then. We don't look at it. We don't look at ourselves in hindsight. And then we fast forward to today, we're seeing the same behaviors come up about the other group doing something in the news. The news not being reliable. You know, people saying whatever they want to say on a public platform and people losing their lives over it. And how do we rectify that? Well, we need to understand what the phenomenon is before we can start changing it. Otherwise, we're only going to be changing parts of a machine. You know, we're not changing the machine itself. So, you know, I think that's something that I think is extremely important and that we need to start reevaluating. And I think one of the ways to do that is by reevaluating who African Americans are and reevaluating our place in this country and how